As I mentioned a moment ago, Jerry's son Brian died last July while in the Hardeman County Jail. You may remember that story. It got a lot of coverage. And so that leaves this family without one of their loved ones at Christmas, and that's certainly a hard time for any family to go through. But they have come up with a very special way to remember Brian and kind of have, you have a tree pretty much standing in for him this Christmas. Has that helped you guys cope with the loss a little bit?
Well, Mary Beth, it has not just a little bit, but a lot. And I want to apologize for the technical difficulties, but if any, it's actually appropriate because if anybody knew Brian, they would know that he's always late, especially at Christmas time. So just the fact that we finally got on the air, we really appreciate it. But yeah, my son Kevin has really worked hard, and our family has worked hard on this tree to kind of as a tribute to Brian, and having it here is a little bit like still having Brian with us.
That is so.
Mary Beth, I know that for me, it has kind of filled the void of not being able to get out and shop for him this year. Just having this project of this tree and having to get out and go find all the different parts of it and everything. It almost kind of took the same place of being out shopping for him. So I know for me, it was very therapeutic, and for other members of our family as well.
And
you put a lot of work into. Well, go ahead.
You guys also asked many of his friends. Of course, he was a professional wrestler as well, followed Jerry into that business. And a lot of people sent you ornaments and sent you pictures and sent you things that spoke of Brian to them, right?
Yeah, that was the actual plan was, just to give a little bit more life and energy. We had, like, family and close friends actually either hand make some of the ornaments or just provide them. And we had a lot of wrestlers like the Gilbert family, Doug Gilbert, Coco Ware, the Dundee, Raven and Buff Bagwell, so many of Brian's wrestling colleagues handmade ornaments and sent them to us. And then there's also the tree is filled with a lot of just personal pictures of things that Brian did throughout his career, and then other little ornaments where we would just handwrite stuff on there that kind of described different things about him, that he was a father, a son, a brother, a friend, a cousin, just all the different things that he is. So it's almost like if you didn't know the person and you was to see this tree, you almost could kind of go away with having a good idea of who this person was and what their life was about, and some of the things that they had accomplished and had done just throughout their life and their career.
And one of the things, Mary Beth, is, as I guess everybody could tell, Brian was a lifelong Pittsburgh Steelers fan, diehard Pittsburgh Steelers fan, and that was the cause of some contention over the years, because I have been a lifelong Cleveland Browns fan, and so to have this kind of a, to have this the colors in this tree in my house is really something special. Also so fitting. Yesterday, the Pittsburgh Steelers lost the game. Now next week, the Steelers are going to, their only way that they'd be able to make the playoffs next week, it depends on if the Cleveland Browns win their game against the Baltimore Ravens. So it's really, it's crazy that this has all happened this way.
Jerry, I tell you what.
Mary Beth, another thing about this that we wanted to do is to share this idea, with a lot of people, because I know it's helped us, and we just wanted to be able to get this idea to other people who might be going through a similar situation, like the first holiday is always going to be the toughest, and something like this, I know it's helped us, and I know a couple other people that I shared the idea with that have done it this year too, so it seems like a good thing, not just for us, but for other people as well.
I tell you what, having known you two for a while, it does not surprise me that, you start doing something for yourself, but you automatically transition to this is how it can help everybody else. Thanks so much for sharing with us your special tree. And Jerry, trash talking to the end. I tell you, Brian is looking down right now, shaking his head. He just knows the Steelers are going to win. We'll see you all later, and you have a Merry Christmas.
Absolutely.
All right. My thoughts are with you guys.